Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have six of the best cheap metal guitars of 2021 that don't suck. We've got offerings from Jackson, Ibanez, Schecter, Squier, and Epiphone. Let's get into it. Let's get started with the most metal looking one of the bunch. This is the Jackson JS32T Rhoads in all of its glory. Of course, this is the guitar made famous by a certain Randy Rhoads back in the day. It's the most affordable Rhoads model to do. And I didn't play one of these properly until a few months ago for a different video, and I've fallen in love with not only with this body shape, but the feel and quality of this super affordable metal guitar. With that, all the prices, I'm not actually gonna mention numerical prices in this video because they fluctuate every other day by like a pound or 50 pence or something. So everything is linked in the description box down below, so you can check it out at pmtonline.co.uk. With that, I'll be playing all the instruments through two Tech cables, going into a Peterson strobe tuner, into the Boss Katana Artist, mic'd up with a Lewitt MTP440 microphone, and it sounds damn good to me. Oh, I'm gonna keep the EQ all at noon. I'm on the Brown Sound channel. One of the cool things about these Rhoads guitars is the fact that there's so much wood here. Besides looking absolutely badass, the whole thing resonates in a very unique way, and they've got a lot of sustain because there's a lot of wood. It's just awesome. That body itself is made from poplar, so it's lovely and lightweight, as resonant as it is. And this is the white one with the black binding, my personal favorite. There's binding on the back. It's that classic, what evolved from the Concord, Randy Rhoads' original guitar. It's just a sight to behold, and you can use it as a weapon at gigs if people get too close to the front or you're adoring fans. Two Jackson high output humbuckers. There is a matte black variant available as well, and a variant with the Floyd Rose, but this is the string through. So strings go through the back, and there's an adjustable bridge here. One volume, one tone, three-way switch. A lovely, slim, sexy satin. So it's nice and smooth under your hand, it's not painted and tacky, maple neck. Amaranth fingerboard, compound radius, so it's more curved down the bottom end for chord work, and it flattens right out towards the higher end when you want to get your shred on, all the way up to the 24, full 2-octave range, jumbo fret. You've got that iconic Jackson headstock with some Jackson tuners. Sticking with that iconicness, shark fin inlays all the way down the board, back to this iconic body, and that's kind of all the specs on this bad lad. Even though it's a bolt-on neck, there's still great, it's been contoured in such a beautiful way that you can get to that second octave, 24th fret, no problem at all. This is just a great metal guitar because it's got the look, it's got the feel, it's got the vibe, and it's bloody pointy. Look at it, the hardtail as well. The string through, which is technically a hardtail, is great for downtuning as well. So it's a great metal guitar if you want to switch between standard tuning, drop D, drop B, or whatever your metal heart desires. Let's hear some more tones, shall we? We'll be right back. That's the Jackson JS32 Rhoads. Look at it, shred away like that, and it's so cool. I love this guitar. This is the Ibanez GRGR131EX in black flat. Flat black. Black. It's pretty black. For people that know Spinal Tap, this is essentially the Spinal Tap black album, which is just, for the people that don't know, a big black square. This is as black as it can get. This is as metal as a metal guitar can get. Matte black poplar body, matte black headstock, gloss black logo, a lovely black purple heart fingerboard with black binding, black reverse shark tooth inlays, black hardware, black pickups. Aye, it's black. And everyone knows that's the most metal color, isn't it? So this is the perfect metal guitar, and it's super affordable as well. It's got some beautiful Ibanez ceramic infinity pickups, but a five-way switch as well. So not only do you get the lovely humbucker tones, like the only tones you could get from the Jackson, but in positions 2 and 4, it splits the coils, so it fires as a single coil as well. Wait, I forgot I was on drop D. It's quite fun playing such a metal guitar and getting like a... So you can go from something like that straight into... Play similar things on all these guitars so you can get a good gist of the difference between them. Just like the Jackson as well, the neck is satin on the back, so it's not all glossy and painted, which can hinder some, especially beginners out there, when your hand gets a bit sweaty and stuff. It can get a bit tacky on the back of the neck. Not with this though, it's nice and satin and smooth. It's a sight to behold as well. Again, 24 jumbo fret, so a full 2-octave range. The guitar feels very tight as well. Again, it's got a string through bridge with six individual block saddles that you can adjust for intonation, but it just feels like a very tight, well put together guitar. Again, great guitar for beginners out there, and also for more experienced guitar players that just want a great looking, sounding and feeling backup. One final awesome feature on this guitar, reverse headstock. That means that the low E string is longer than usual, because usually that would be reversed, that would be the shortest, and the high E would be the longest. But because of this, this makes it great for downtuning, because it's a different tension, more accustomed to downtuning, like if you want to go drop B, drop A, or even drop D. It's a totally different kind of tension and feel than a regular guitar, which suits this kind of playing a lot more. So that is the Ibanez GRGR131EX in flat black. This is the Epiphone SG Special, and to look at, as opposed to that crazy black Ibanez and the pointy Jackson, it's not the most metal guitar in the world. However, this body shape guitar helped conceive the idea of metal with the likes of Tony Iommi, and for regulars on this channel, you may know that the SG is my favorite guitar of all time, and this is the most affordable SG you can buy, the Epiphone SG Special VE. In all of its glory, this is the cherry red one, and it's absolutely gorgeous. Again, it shares a poplar body, it's becoming a theme in this video, but it has a mahogany veneer, so it's got the same kind of grain as the expensive Epiphones and Gibsons. A coom neck, which is the same wood family as mahogany, just a little bit more sustainable, and it's a slim taper D profile. The whole guitar as well is that lovely cherry satin. It also comes in cherry black and walnut as well. The walnut one is very 70s AC/DC. Traditional Epiphone headstock with the clipped ears, Epiphone tuners, moving down the neck, you've got dot inlays, 22 medium jumbo frets, all the way down to these beautiful ceramic 8 magnet Epiphone humbuckers, one volume, one tone, three-way switch, traditional Epiphone Gibson style stop bar tailpiece and tunematic bridge. You can't really tell the bolt-on this guitar because a lot of SGs have quite a big heel anyways, well, not the ones based off the 60s ones, but that's a totally different video completely, so you kind of don't really tell, you can't feel that it's a bolt-on, but yeah. This guitar is one of the most iconic metal shapes, in my humble opinion, and it's not a lot of money in 2021. Loads of doom guys, well, like people that like sludgy drone metal and stuff, always seem to enjoy 70s, more specifically SGs and like big orange stacks and stuff. So there is still a big place in metal for the SG. Besides that little tuning mishap there as well, this guitar has stayed in tune slightly better than the other ones as well. Like that tune that's up at the start. These are all brand new guitars as well, by the way. This one's holding a tuning lovely. The neck pickup is beautiful on this guitar as well. Fun little fact as well, Paranoid was actually played on the neck pickup. And that is the Epiphone, it's really light, I'm chuckling it about, SG-Special VE in Worn Cherry. I love this guitar so much. This is a really, really gorgeous guitar to play. This is the Schecter C-6 Plus, and it's ever so slightly more expensive than the rest of these guys. I think it's just over £300-ish, but it does feel quite premium. Schecter's always have a way of making affordable guitars feel like premium guitars, and this feels like one of the most premium ones that I'm demoing in this video for you fine folk watching. Basswood body. This is a quilted maple variant, however, this is just a veneer, so it's almost like a photograph, so it's not actual fancy wood, is just made to look like that, which is fine. Like, the audience don't care when you're shredding away, and when you look at it on your wall, you're gonna think that's a damn fine guitar. It also comes in like purple and red and stuff, but this is the translucent black variant. String through, tunematic bridge, one volume, one tone, three-way switch, Schecter Diamond Plus pickups, and check out the contouring on the body. Like, you can kind of half see the basswood grain besides all the dust on the back as well. Beautiful guitar, but that contouring to get to that 24th fret is, you can play the pickup if you want. It's a really, really easy guitar to play. Slim C, maple neck, rosewood fingerboard with 24 medium jumbo frets on. No, extra jumbo frets, so you can really, really dig in. That classic Schecter headstock up top with Schecter branded tuners. Yeah, this thing just feels a little bit more, not special, because that SG is really special. It's all personal opinion. I just quite enjoy the way this feels, and I think you will as well, hence why it's in this list. It's got a 14-inch radius fingerboard, which was lovely and flat. If you're unsure what radius means, it's essentially, think of a 14-inch circle. And the higher the number, the bigger the circle will be. So the flatter the outside of the radius of the circle will be. So like 12-inch, 14-inch, this is 14-inch. And it's just really flat and really gorgeous. These pickups seem to have a lot more clarity to them, not a lot more, slightly more clearer, and they've got a bit more power. I feel like they've got more output. Output doesn't always necessarily mean distortion. They haven't like got more gain or something, just more output, so there's more of them there. That's great. That's the Schecter C6 Plus in all of its glory. (laughs) And that's how you get around Iron Maiden copyright. This is the Squier Bullet FSR Fender Special Run HSS Strat. And the reason I believe this is one of the best metal guitars, the best affordable metal guitars of 2021 that doesn't suck, is the fact that, same as that SG, metal bands back in the day, back in the 70s, didn't have access to Schecters and Deans and BC Riches and Jacksons, because it just wasn't really a thing. If you wanted a hot rod metal guitar, you had to modify a Fender Strat, or something like that. Put a humbucker in a Fender Strat, and this is exactly what this is. This is one of the Fender Special Edition ones, two color sunbursts, all the hardware is black. But most importantly, I enjoy it for playing metal because it's got a string through bridge as opposed to one of the Fender tremolos. It's that classic Strat design, not like one of these slightly modified Strat designs like Schecter and Jackson and stuff. This is the real deal because it's a Squier. Humbucker in the bridge, two single coils, so it's different to the other ones. There's lovely single coil tone. If you do want to get your Stevie Ray Vaughan or Jimi Hendrix on, we've got that beautiful humbucker in the bridge, which actually has a lot more punch than I was expecting. Five-way switch, so you can get all the beautiful single coil tones of the bridge in position two, as well as the rest. One volume, two tones, single ply, black scratch plate, which is just lovely. A Slim C profile satin maple neck, again with that satin. Indian laurel fingerboard with 21, so it's more traditional Fender frets instead of 22 or 24, and those frets are medium jumbo. 9.5 inch radius fingerboard as well, so it's a lot more curved than the Schecters and stuff I was talking about before, or the compound radius Jacksons, but doesn't mean it's unpleasant, doesn't mean it's not great for metal. If it was good for the lads in Iron Maiden, if it was good for Kirk Hammett and Eddie Van Halen, it's good for us, right? Common theme though, the body is poplar again. So I think that Schecter is the only one without a poplar body because it's basswood. I don't know if I mentioned that before, but yeah, poplar's great and affordable. So you can rock out looking this good. Not me, the guitar. That's the Squier Bullet Fender Special Run FSR Hardtail HSS Strat. And it's lovely, isn't it? This is the Jackson GSJS11 Dinky in metallic red, and it's just mint. A couple of years ago, I did a review of the GSJS11 Dinky in white, and these days you can now get them in metallic red. And according to Alex, the lovely videographer, this thing looks amazing on camera. It looks amazing in person, but apparently it photographs really well. I wanted to include this guitar as well because obviously we started with the Jackson Rhoads. I wanted to show you can get great metal guitars from Jackson for a great price, really not expensive, that aren't all pointy and daft. This is a traditional dinky and it absolutely screams. Poplar body, those same Jackson high output pickups, one volume, one tone, three-way switch, so no single coils on this, but who needs them when you sound and look this good? I want to include this as well because there's a tremolo, a lovely Jackson 2-point tremolo. So if you dive bomb it on it quite a bit, you might knock out a tune slightly, but if you get some lock and tuners or set it up properly, you will be able to hammer it quite a bit. Lovely Slim C profile maple neck with that gorgeous contouring to get up to that 22nd. How many frets are on this? 24. So 22 medium jumbo frets on this 12-inch radius Amaral fingerboard. Again, all satin, that iconic classic Jackson headstock. And yeah, that's it. It absolutely screams. It's a gorgeous guitar. That bridge pickup absolutely screams, doesn't it? Let's hear some gorgeous neck stuff now. So that, folks, was the Jackson JS11 Dinky in metallic red, and it's just utterly gorgeous. This thing looks as good as it sounds and plays, and damned as it play and sound good. And that's the end of six of my favorite metal guitars of 2021 that don't suck. Please comment down below your favorite. Do you have one yourself and you want to expand on what I've been chatting about? There's obviously plenty more than just six, so feel free to include the ones that I've missed. I just didn't want to stand here for 3 hours and talk to you about 1400 guitars. As amazing as they are, these are my favorites, the specs and why they're my favorites. But I want your opinion as well, so please let me know. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on any of the guitars I've chatted about here today, or this beautiful Boss Katana Artist amp, click the links in the description box down below and get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of them all with nice filters on. I've been Dagan and I'll see you next time.